Hi Anshu,
Yes.
Good morning.
Hi Kalyan sir, good morning.
So your topic is excitement.
Yeah. So when I got the topic, the first thing I did is I just checked the dictionary what it says.
Okay.
So okay. Yeah. So the dictionary, there are two, three definitions given there. So one was feeling enthusiastic and eager about something happening or something going to happen. There was another definition which was saying ki being happy about something coming up or something actually happening, but not in a calm way. Not in a calm way, yes.
Mm-hmm.
So these two definitions, I felt that not exactly same, but first one seemed like more neutral kind of, like feeling enthusiastic is enthusiasm, in my understanding, can be a valid sensation out of any physical experience also. Mm-hmm. But the other one, like when it says not in a calm way, it says there is some extra, like as if we have some special liking for the event going to happen, or maybe we are driven by some idea, we have some overwhelming emotion.
So can it happen about the past event also?
Yes. It can happen. So if I can share one example. So like water rides, right? There was one, I'm sharing my own experience, my first water ride that I did. So when we went to the place, I was driven towards that water ride. It's first thing as it is. So I went for the ride, and the experience of the ride was amazing. Like I felt that at the end of the ride, I felt in a state of meditation, kind of that there was nothing there. Some sense of contentment, happiness, satisfaction was there, and it was very pleasurable experience for me. So thereafter, whenever I went, I always felt very excited about the water rides, because the past experience was very pleasurable. So whenever I go, I see some kind of excitement in me for the water rides. So when I see this, there are certain aspects. So if past experience was good, and we are excited because the experience was very pleasurable for us. So if there can be idea behind it, there may not be idea also behind it. Because some, if we see our personal life, some things may be less pleasurable, some things may be more pleasurable. So if we see a mango also, mango for some people, mango is sweet. For some people, something else is sweeter than that. So this is there, like something gives more pleasure, something gives less pleasure. So what gives more pleasure?
Gives the excitement.
You can say enthusiasm is there for doing that activity. For if some experience is giving me some pleasure, more than something else. So when the next time the same experience, we are going to see that the same thing we are going to do. Enthusiasm or affinity for that, for doing that, or some kind of excitement. Because of the past memory. So I think we also need to compare excitement and enthusiasm, because I see that I'm still questioning. So when I see, I feel somewhere they are similar kind of emotions. But maybe if you see the second definition, that excitement is not in a calm way, then there's some ideation also. So if enthusiasm is there and then we have some idea along with it, then maybe that becomes excitement.
So can we inquire this, apart from these definitions given by the dictionaries?
Yes.
What is our processing about this word or the experience of excitement? By the way, Anshu, this video conversation is being recorded, and we'll be sharing it for further inquiry by the viewers also, whoever are interested.
Okay.
Yeah,
that is fine.
Yes. So what is exactly the processing, the inner processing, when we hear this word? Because see, the word is very limited expression of the processing.
Yes.
Be it from the dictionary or otherwise.
Right.
So what is exactly the processing, if we can inquire deeply about this? But,
okay. So when I hear the word, heard the word, I feel ki it is some feeling of joy. And also there is some kind of curiosity in this. So any event, anything, any experience, which we know that we are going to do something and we feel excited. So if I say my own understanding, how I feel about it, my own internal processing. So whenever something pleasurable I'm going to do, I feel the feeling of excitement. That is a lot of enthusiasm. Energy is there. Some energy is like, I feel energetic about it. And I also feel curious, so what it can bring to me.
Being curious about the next happening,
yeah,
can it be termed as excitement?
No, I don't say only curiosity. There is curiosity and there is a lot of
expectation also. Expectation due to the past experience or maybe.
Yeah, you are right. That's what I said, that I feel there is some idea, subtle idea also there behind it. Mm-hmm. That in past, I had this experience and it could be the same. So that mm-hmm. kind of expectation definitely is there. Like I can say one example that I like to have guests at home and I like to cook for them or entertain them or like these things I like to do because in past, I have very good experience about it. But I can also say that there was a time when I was very excited and I welcomed people and the experience wasn't as I expected. So as you said, there is expectation. So I realized that after that moment on, the enthusiasm for doing such thing was reduced because there was the expectation somewhere was not met. It was not a very prominent feeling, but the subtle sense of this was there. I don't find it anymore, not anymore, but level of excitement has gone down because now it is not as I was expecting it to be.
Mm-hmm.
So that is there. In fact, I also relate excitement with the sense of anxiety because any event is coming up, I'm excited about it. But I'm not able to wait for it. So there is overwhelming emotion. So I want to do it because I had past good experience about it. And then because this event is not yet come, so there is a sense of anxiety when it will come and all that. So the energy gets zapped. And then if the event is happening and then it did not happen the way I expected, then there's a disappointment also.
So definitely excitement is a physiological sensation.
Yes.
Which is not perennial. Like continuous excitement cannot happen for anyone.
Yes.
It happens for a specific event, special event, special
yes.
person.
Yes.
All
yes.
those things, right? So
yeah. So yeah, some sense of special liking for something is there.
So it that means is where it fragments the moments from the whole through the excitement. Do you understand that?
Yeah. Yes. I can understand that. Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So what is the impact on energy if we fragment?
It zaps my energy because. Definitely, I'm not able to. I have brought an idea there. Definitely, because there is a physical experience and I have sensations there. But the moment there is some idea coming up, some expectation coming up, then I said, right, excitement comes a lot of times, like most of the times, excitement comes with some kind of anxiety also because emotion is overwhelming. Mm-hmm. Because of the idea and it can also lead to disappointment if the
expectation is not
expectation
met.
Is not met, yes. So yes. A lot
so
of energy
since you
gets
brought
zapped
the
there.
Topic or brought the mention of curiosity also, but being
yes.
curious or inquisitiveness. So
yes.
if the inquisitiveness is optimum, then excitement will not be there.
Right.
As I understand, isn't it? Like if you perennially inquisitive about it, that let me check what is that. So whatsoever the past experience may be, but this experience is going to be a fresh and new experience for me. And I'm absolutely consistently curious about it.
Yeah, then will curious that, about it. And that also brings some kind of that we talk like may element that
yes,
something may or may not happen. So I'm ready for whatever may happen. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so that is there. But I also see one more aspect. That is where
I got stuck with that word that I'm ready. I don't know whether I'm ready or not. Is it? If I pre-decided that I'm ready.
Open. I can say maybe at the.
I'm curious about my response also of that event.
Yes.
But
yes,
whether
yes.
I'm comfortable with it or not, I'm ready for it or not, I don't know. Because it is yet to come.
Right. Actually, I was, I should have used the word open. I'm open to the whatever comes up.
So
uses of word was wrong. Yes. But there is one more aspect I was thinking about. So again, the same this enthusiasm versus excitement thing. So there are, I can say that there is one scenario where a person is having so much of energy in him or her that anything that is coming up, he's feeling, he's eager to do it. Like so much of bubbling energy.
He's eager or he's open? Because there are two different things. Like if somebody is eager to experience that event, then there is a lot of predispositions. And if somebody is open to experience that event, so two level of energies are different. Like first, eager when we say, that means it is a stimulated energy. It's not a balanced energy state. But if somebody is open, so the difference between eagerness and openness, eagerness will have that excitement. Isn't it?
I know. Even I feel, because I relate eagerness with excitement also. Yeah. But my this was occurring to me that a person who has a lot of energy and anything he comes across, maybe eagerness is also there. Open and maybe plus eagerness, maybe some predisposition also there. But there are some people who are happy doing anything.
No, when you say eagerness, what do you mean exactly? That's more important. Actually,
sense of curiosity about anything that is going to come up.
So if that event is not happening, suppose for anything specific, if you are eager, eager, and that thing is not happening, then what is your state of being? Yeah, that will happen. That's a separate thing. But what will happen to your eagerness? That's the question. The eagerness that you are terming, what will happen to your eagerness if that event is not occurring?
See,
that's a bigger question. Yeah. You understood that?
Yeah, I understood the question. But what I am saying is a different scenario. I am saying a scenario in which, as you said, openness. I'm not able to exactly put it up, but what I'm saying is that a person has, like if you see a child, a child is having lot of energy, lot of energy is there. And if you see a child, he is playing, he's doing everything. He seems like quite, the child's neural system is not developed so much. So I don't know whether that example is good to quote here or not. But then if you see a child, the child seems to be, as I see it, they seem to be excited about everything they do. They will do this, they will do that. And like so much of energy is there. I'm not telling every child, but a lot of children are like that. So they seem to be happy, go lucky about everything. This word is, I'm just using metaphorically, but I'm trying to connect with the level of energy one has. So if somebody has a lot of energy.
Can we try and understand the level of energy in a state of being open? and level yeah, of energy yeah. in state of being excited.
Yeah, we can. So, I think I'm able to understand what you are pointing to. You are telling that
excitement is a state of stimulated energy.
Yes. I can sense it.
I'm not enforcing or trying to establish it. I'm just trying to ask you what is your processing about these two state of being.
Right, I understand because even I am also questioning that only that excitement. I see a sense of extra, sense of overwhelming emotion. So that I sense it there. So
so the question is it sustainable?
Yeah, that's what I got it. So even when I'm telling that a person is having a lot of energy and he's anything coming up, he's doing it. But if there is any kind of like extra emotion or eagerness, as you mentioned, the energy will get zapped, and then so that absolutely that it will not be sustainable because at one point of time some kind of disappointment will come, and of course. So I think being open.
Yes.
To events, it is so that is what we call enthusiasm.
What was the term that we may opt to use? But openness means not about a specific event or a moment. It's a state of being for an individual, moment by moment, perennial. The openness means you are not looking for some special event.
Yeah, right.
So whenever there is a specification of the special event, that time the excitement will come.
Excitement, yes.
Eagerness will come. Openness means whatever is going to happen, you are curious and perennially curious about it. That the movement of that event, you are observing, you are going deep into understanding that further and further and further without any end to it, without any destination. That's what is the openness, as I comprehend.
Okay, so,
I don't know. Are you able to comprehend the openness similar way or something else?
Yes. I am able to get it. I am able to understand it that way only.
Hmm.
So if we see that, so a person with energy and also open, that person, any activity he does.
So here, if an individual is open, that means that individual has not built up any opinion about any. So opinion is the energy zapper.
Opinions
zap the energy. So by default, that individual will be bubbling with energy. If an individual is open, he will be.
I'm able to perceive it. Yes.
He or she will be having bubbling of energy. Like he will be bubbling with the energy. Abundance of energy will be there.
So anybody who is absolutely. So anybody who is open, because he's open, he's not creating any fragments in his mind about anything. So the person is free of ideas. So any event coming up, the person will be fully involved, but the involvement will not come as like psychologically, there will not be any overwhelming stuff, but physically he's fully into it.
Yeah, so, because of the overwhelming of energy, abundance of energy, action will not be compromised.
Yes.
When you have
now
energy.
So, do we see
conventionally that excitement is over glamorized?
Yes, of course. In fact, happiness is also over-glamorized because when I see if a person who is open and but energy is there, so he's doing things, but in the way of expression, there is no extra emotion or anything. Somebody may see that person as ki kuch dikha nahi raha, that he's not showing any emotion, but the person is enjoying because the mind is free. He's open and he's physically, like to the action he's giving his fullest.
And
is also
not showing up not showing up of emotion doesn't mean that separation of emotion.
Yes. But there, I'm telling
there is no occurrence of emotion at all. There is no occurrence of emotion if that individual is curious enough and open enough, isn't
it? Yes, of course.
So we misterm sometimes that individual is suppressing the emotion. Generally, it is termed that individual see how he is suppressing his own emotion. So it is not necessarily that individual is suppressing the emotion. It is not occurring. That is not, it is not being expressed.
So my understanding is that to enjoy anything to the fullest, one needs to have enough energy and openness. So if once that is there, the person doesn't have to express anything outwardly. Ki, I'm enjoying it. Doesn't have to express.
If it comes, if it comes outwardly, it's fine. But otherwise, there is no plan to express.
Yeah, there is no
outward.
Plan, and there is no There is no compulsion. Like there is no obligation for the person, because person knows. Understanding is there from inside.
Yes.
And
order of energy and openness will be openness and energy.
Yes, right.
So it's not
course.
that
of course.
Individual will have energy then being open. If the individual is open, then by default, he will be having abundance of energy.
Right. But the other way also is to some extent is possible. If a person doesn't have enough energy, the person will not be able to inquire much. And sometimes the openness doesn't come up in that case. So that also one scenario can be there.
That's definitely a deeper thing. That means you are saying that if someone is not open, then definitely there is a zapping of energy happening in that individual. That is why that individual is not open.
Yes. That is also there.
So excitement, what is our proposal? Like if somebody is suffering from excitement, then what can we propose, or what that individual may opt to dissolve the excitement? Not to dissolve, but what will end up dissolving the
excitement
for that individual? Not in a negative term, but more vital term. Yeah.
I think inquiry needs to be done. Once
an
the person
identification of the fragmentation.
Yes. In fact, yeah. So inquiry, once the person inquires into it, he will be able to observe that there is fragmentation happening. So that identification will happen. And I think observation is very important to observe oneself in that state of being. So what I have learned recently is that a lot of times even if one is not able to go deeply into it, at least observing the state of mind may or may not, that state of mind itself brings a lot of identification. So then the energy starts releasing. Then maybe the person goes deeper, and he or she will be able to see what is happening.
Yeah. So I'd like to add that observation means there is no hatred towards it.
Yes.
Neither
yes.
there is a praise, extra praise or applauding.
Yeah. Neutrally observing oneself. Because again, if there is hatred, then again another level of fragmentation is
fragmentation
happening.
Will be there, and energy is happening. Start.
Yes, right.
Beautiful.
I think because I know my state of being, so a lot of learning for me as well in this discussion.
Yeah, a lot of revelation actually. That
revelation.
We might end up glamorizing excitement because of the conventional proposal or borrowed ideas and all. But ultimately, at the energy level, excitement is an energy zapper.
Yes. In fact, there was a time when I used to be excited about things. And there was a time when I felt lower energy. And I used to think there was an obligation that I'm not getting excited about things. So that obligation used to be there.
I have to be excited.
Excited. Yes. So that obligation used to be there. I have to be excited about it. I have to be happy about things. You understand that?
Yes,
so that used to be there. Mm. But now there is understanding. So I get it.
Mm.
Yeah.
Great, Anshu. Thanks for your time and inquiring together.
And thanks to you. Yes. It was interesting. I think a lot of revelations happened. So interesting discussion. Yes.
So we'll continue our journey.
Yes.
Thank you.